knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave Explains.
At this point in the series, it's time to start digging into Nephrozoa, which contains most of the animals we are likely familiar with. But before doing so, we have one more rather interesting phylum to discuss, and that is Xenocoelomorpha. The animals in phylum Xenocoelomorpha are widely considered to be the sister group to all other bilaterally symmetrical animals, that is, every animal on the cladogram we haven't covered yet. So far, we've studied the phyla Porifera, Placozoa, Cnidaria, and Ctenophora. All of these phyla fall outside of the traditional classification of triploblastic bilateria. This term includes animals that have a left and right side that are mirror images of each other, and three unique germ cell layers, the ectoderm, mesoderm, and endoderm. All Nephrozoans are further split up into the three superphyla we discussed at the beginning of the series, namely Deuterostomia, Ecdysozoa, and Spiralia. You'll notice, however, that there is one phylum that is part of the triploblastic bilateria, but outside of Nephrozoa. That is phylum Xenocoelomorpha. These unassuming worm-like creatures actually play a key role in understanding the rest of kingdom Animalia, since they are considered to be the most basal group of bilaterally symmetrical triploblastic animals. This is due in part to the fact that they, like the Cnidarians, have only one opening, but like almost all other animals, they are bilateral triploblasts. Phylum Xenocoelomorpha is further divided into the sister clades Xenoturbellida and Acoelomorpha. Xenoturbellida contains a single genus, Xenoturbella, and six species, including the recently discovered Xenoturbella churro, named as such for its resemblance to the famous fried dough pastry, and Xenoturbella monstrosa, which can grow up to 20 centimeters in length. All members of this clade are dorsoventrally flattened and possess a ciliated ring furrow, a thick epidermis, longitudinal, circular, and radial muscles, a ventral mouth that opens into the gut, and an anterior balance sensory receptor known as a statocyst that is used for orientation. They all lack a circulatory, respiratory, and nervous system and have no defined organs except for the statocyst. The Acoelomorphs are tiny flat worms, less than 5 millimeters in length, that are often found living between grains of sediment, floating as planktonic organisms, or crawling over the surfaces of corals. Like the Xenoturbellidas, the Acoelomorphs have a ciliated epidermis and a statocyst. However, some Acoelomorphs also have pigment spot ocelli, or simple eyes, that are capable of detecting light. This group contains about 350 species, most of which are in class Acoela, which contains the shilly-shally, or mint sauce, worm. These animals are native to the Atlantic coast of Europe, where they have been observed from Wales to the south of Portugal. Their bright green pigmentation intrigued scientists in the 1870s, and they have been the subject of numerous studies ever since. It turns out that the shilly-shally worms get their green pigmentation from the interaction of their own bodies and the symbiotic microalgae, Tetracelmus convolutae, that they host under their epidermis. Juvenile worms are born without photosynthetic symbionts and must obtain them indirectly from the environment through their ventral orifice that functions like a mouth. However, at no point in their development do they have a digestive system. So unlike the hermatypic corals that rely in part on photosynthetic symbionts, the shilly-shally worms rely entirely on their symbionts to survive. Juveniles that are incapable of collecting enough microalgae or are experimentally prevented from doing so will die. And with that, we've now covered every animal phylum outside of the major clade Nephrozoa. And since this clade contains almost all of the animals you've ever heard of, you can probably imagine that we are just getting started. Let's move forward and continue exploring the animal kingdom.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.